I've got one of my test rigs here and I've disconnected the 6mm cable that I've maybe tested for continuity, CPC and polarity. And it might be a case now I'm thinking what I can do now is carry out the insulation resistance test with it disconnected from the consumer unit. And I might want to do that because there's some other things in here that raise concerns when carrying out the test. It says about making sure your SPDs are disconnected when carrying out your insulation resistance test, as well as RCDs because they contain electronic components. So if we look here, we've got a row of RCBOs, which will obviously have electronic components in. The circuit I've disconnected also has a ton of electronics in it because this is an AFDD. So effectively, it's got a mini computer inside here. And the last thing I'd want to do is pass 500 volts through it and potentially damage it. So I'm thinking I'll just leave it disconnected. I'll carry out my insulation resistance test and then I'll reconnect it and torque up the settings accordingly. Well, that could be the case and you can do that, but one of the conductors will need to be in place. So as you look at the consumer unit, you can see I've got no supply coming into here. There's no feed in, exactly the same as the images shown in the on-site guide, and I've got all three conductors disconnected. But one of these conductors needs to be in place, and that one being the circuit protective conductor, needs connecting to my earth bar, and my earth bar needs connecting to my external earth source. So I've got, in this case, my 16mm earthing conductor that will go down maybe to pick up my combined neutral earth on a TNCS earthing arrangement, or onto the sheath of the cable on a TNS earthing arrangement. So that must be in place, as well as any protective bonding. Well, there's no protective bonding in here to gas and water, but it could be that this earthing conductor goes down to an MET and the MET has my bonding in place. So I must connect this conductor to the earth bar, which is connected to the source earth, as well as any protective bonding before carrying out my insulation resistance test. I can then carry out my insulation resistance test with these conductors disconnected, removing anything that I'm worried about down here, SPDs, AFDDs, RCBOs, etc., in order that I can carry out that test. But it's vitally important that this conductor is in place and connected to the earth source.